back. Guys, I found the most epic, ridiculous toy. It's a gross-out meter. Look at this thing. It's a Beetlejuice gross-out meter.
Look at this thing.
You slap it on... Right?
Oh, I said it once. Oh, no. So, in this guy, you slap this thing on people's arms, and you find out how gross they are. I'm gonna take this, and I'm gonna go to Walmart. I'm over on Boulder. Yeah, I'm gonna break it. There's two, so they spin randomly and they just tell you how nasty you are. You are really gross. I might have to buy this or track this down. I wonder if there were other toys like this. I'll go around the neighborhood. Get a reading on the gross people in your neighborhood. Thanks to that guy.
Guys, it is nasty windy out. Take a look out the window. That is what the valley looks like here in Vegas. It is disgusting. Like, look at that sky. Normally it's very blue, but it is right now very, very dusty. But I do have to go on a little ride across the world, so I'm taking Joaquin with me. We're gonna go hit up, we're gonna go pick up the kids. We're not gonna hit up anything. We might hit up a store afterwards, but either way, me and my boy are gonna go get my boy. Sweet boy. You guys can probably hear the wind, but normally, from here is where you can see the strip. And there's a whole lot of nothing out there. It's kind of wild. You can barely see it, but it's there. There's the strip. Take a look at that. I love seeing that, where the sun breaks through crazy looking clouds, because it is like super dark over here. It's not even that late. It's like 4 in the afternoon, but that looks pretty epic. I love it. You look close enough, you can see how quickly the clouds are actually moving. It's nuts. Oh, I can feel the truck just getting pushed around. I'm at a stoplight, and I can feel the truck getting pushed around by this wind. It's nuts! Guys, it's been a minute. I feel like it's been a little while since I've done one of these brambles. It's been too long. So I've been busy. In fact, there's some news. There's a whole story here. There really is a whole story here. So the news came out recently. If you follow me on Twitter, you might have seen this. But Maker Studios, who I was a part of for the last 2 years or so, and there's a weird J.J. Abrams light flare going on. Maker Studios, who I was partnered with for the last 2 years, feels like longer, at least 2 years. I'm going to be let go from Maker at the end of the month. This is a good thing. This is a great thing. Because I've been actually trying to get out of Maker since my contract renewed in August. Because they haven't really done much for me in the last year. So, when it started, when I first joined up with Maker, it was great. It was actually really wonderful. I had nothing but good things to say. I actually scored a Disney World trip out of it. If you guys remember that whole Disney Side Creator Conference. If you've been around with the channel that long, thank you, because we're friends. Like, I seriously consider you a friend at this point. If you've been around that long, I know you. I'm pretty sure I know you. If you comment and stuff. I'm sure there's people who may watch and don't comment that have been around that long. But still, either way, if you're still here from then, that's when that goes back to. That was because of Maker. So, shortly after that, there were a couple offers here and there. I went to D23 because of Maker. I had my own little panel where I live painted some shoes, it was what it was. It was fun-ish. So here's the thing about Maker. There's always been a little bit of communication error? Miscommunicate? I don't know how you want to phrase this, but some kind of miscommunication with Maker. They've never been the best communicators in the world. How about that? That's a fair assessment, I think. Because even with like the thing I did at D23, I went and they had me come out and they're like, okay, we need you to like fill up an hour with entertainment. So they're like, the idea was that I was going to go live paint shoes. We're going to give them away. It was going to be fun. And I did that. And they were like, okay, so you got to make sure you have an hour's worth of work. And I did. I like timed it, which is impossible, which is like, think about it. That's impossible to like complete a piece of art and set out that you have 1 hour, exactly 1 hour left worth of artwork to finish. I never finish my artwork. My artwork's never done. No matter what it is, it's never finished. But to, like, in your mind, get to the point where, like, okay, I can finish this in an hour. And yes, and I did, and I, like, planned it, and I made it happen so that I had an hour's worth of artwork left to do so I could fill out this panel. And they get there, and they're like, okay, so what do you want to talk about? And I'm like, talk? You'd want me to paint. I'm not, like, you know that when I paint, I don't, like, talk. I record myself, and I, like, shorten. It's like they had no understanding of what I did or anything. So, that being said, the whole D23 thing was interesting. Luckily, they had a really nice girl there. I forget her name, but she handled the crowd and asked me questions as I painted, and it ended up being really fun, even though there was that whole miscommunication to begin with. And then 45 minutes in, even though I had an hour's worth of work, so 15 minutes early, they're like, hey, are you done? Because we need to get the next people prepped and ready, which is super annoying. Like, if you're going to tell me an hour, tell me an hour. If you only want 45 minutes, tell me 45 minutes, which they didn't. And that was, like, a little stressful because they were like, hey, we need to get you off the stage because, you know, we got to get the next people on. And that was, like, that bummed me out a little bit because I'm like, really? You want these things complete or what? Like, what are we doing here? So, miscommunication, which is a running theme with Maker. So, after that, the next good thing to happen was a Disney XD. You guys might remember me doing this. The Disney XD Maker Spark thing. So, basically, we pitched an idea to Maker for a TV show for Disney XD. If you don't know what Disney XD is, what are you doing here? Not really, I love you guys, but Disney XD is like the Disney Channel, but more geared towards boys, ages like 8 to 13. So I pitched a show for a travel channel, or travel show kind of deal, based on a little boy who was more of like a video game, like a homebody, just wanted to stay home and do nothing but play PlayStation or whatever, and his dad, me, drug him out on this countrywide, like, you know, cross country through America road trip. And that was the idea, that was the premise for the show, is that I dragged him out because I wanted to make a, like, reality YouTube series, all the while he was being dragged along. So it was like a show within a show. They went for it, they gave us the money to make the show, and we went and we did one episode out in Arizona, and it was a lot of fun. Actually, I think it was really good. It's some of my best work, to be honest, as far as video stuff goes. And, of course, nothing, like, I mean, something happened from it. Actually, it's on Disney XD, so if you have the Disney XD app, you can currently go on Disney XD and watch it. It's there, Disney by Maker. For now, it's there. So, that was finished in December of 2015. So, not last December, but the December before that. I heard nothing until March, about a year ago. And they said, hey, Disney XD likes it. We're going to put it on Disney XD itself. So, like, cool, not only did Maker like it, but Disney XD liked what I did. So they were going to put it on the channel. So it's on the channel, like I said. But after that, nothing really came to fruition. And the rest of the year, this was in March 31st, is I think when the video actually dropped and went live. From then until now, there was literally nothing. No activity, no offers, nothing from Maker. And that was the whole draw, is that they had these offers. I got royalty-free music. If you watch my Star Wars videos, there's this weird generic track. I think it's called Galaxy Far, Far Away. That sounds like Star Wars, but it's not Star Wars. But it's royalty-free, so I can use it and not lose out on any ad revenue that I do when I make those videos. So that's that. So that's why they were worth keeping around. That's why it was worth keeping my partnership with Maker, was for that royalty-free music. So last October, they announced that one of the big groups that has royalty-free music called Audio Micro, they were losing their contract with them, and they were not going to be renewing it. So there goes half of our music library, gone. And then, fortunately, that was October. My contract auto-renewed in August. Now, given that they were changing a big chunk of their terms by losing a big, huge benefit, I tried to get out. I was like, you know what? You guys haven't had any offers in the last year. It's kind of weird. Nothing's going on. Some of the people I knew at Maker were let go in July, shortly after VidCon, because I went to the Maker Studios party at VidCon, and something felt off. It really did. It wasn't the same as it was the year before. And then, you know, a couple weeks later, everybody gets let go, or a bunch of people get let go, and something just seems off at Maker. And then they lost Audio Micro, which is a huge, huge audio library. So I'm like, okay, so there's one more benefit gone. Why am I giving you a cut of my ad revenue? Which, by the way, if you're ever thinking about joining an MCN, which means multi-channel network, that's how that works. They take a cut of your ad revenue off your YouTube videos, And in exchange, they offer you certain benefits, be it offers, royalty-free music, brand deals, whatever they want to promise you. Honestly, they're usually garbage. The only reason I went with Maker Studios was because Disney had bought them a few months before they reached out to me. I was like, hey, Disney bought this company. This company's reaching out to me. I want to work with Disney. No brainer. Let's do it. And at the time I signed with them, I had like 200 subscribers. Like, there was seriously like 240 subscribers at that time. Things have progressed a little bit since then, which is really awesome. Like, the fact that I have enough of you here to actually watch me ramble about this is amazing. And some of you have been around since then, which is nuts, which is really nuts. And really, I seriously appreciate it. But, so through all that, here we come. January of this year, January 2017, I get an email from, it might have been February, but a few weeks back. I get an email from Maker saying, hey, we're changing our model on what we're going to do. And of course, there are a couple news articles that come out about Maker saying they're going to be cutting down their channels that they're partnered with to, like, one place said 300, one said 1,000. It's kind of all over the place. But either way, they're cutting down from 55,000 down to a very small amount of people that they want to be partnered with and working with. As soon as this happened, I was like, okay, this is my out. Let me out of my contract. I don't want to be giving you a percentage of my money. If you're really not doing anything for me, sure, I use that one Star Wars track, but honestly, it's not worth a percentage, a sizable percentage. At this point, the contract's over 30% of my ad revenue, which when I started at 200 subscribers, literally amounted to a few pennies. It was like 10 cents. No big deal. I'm paying 10 cents for music that would cost me a couple hundred a month to have that subscription. No brainer. Of course, you're going to sign with them and they're owned by Disney. Duh. 2 years later, I'm making a bit more money through YouTube and my videos and the ad revenue, and they're not doing anything for me. So why am I giving you more than a few cents each month and not getting anything out of it? So, you know, that's where it starts to bug me, which is why I wanted out of the contract. So, yesterday, Monday, I get an email from Maker saying, hey, we're going to release you at the end of the month, sometime between the 27th and the 31st, I believe. And, of course, a lot of Maker partners, because they're slicing down from 55,000 creators down to, like, 1,000 or 300, depending on what article you read, they're getting rid of everybody. So everybody got fired from Maker. We'll say fired. I've never been fired before. That's kind of cool. It is what it is. But, so I'm so excited. I'm going to lose the Star Wars track. So because I've lost the Star Wars track, last night I focused on recording all of these unboxings for all these Star Wars videos so I can get them edited and out before the end of the month. And I'm not going to be done with Star Wars by the end of the month, but I'm going to be done using that track. So I went and recorded as much as I can so I can just spend the month, like, every day dropping a new Star Wars video. So that might mean less vlogs, which has kind of been the case anyways, because let's be real. I have to just be totally transparent with you guys. The people who watch my channel, my audience as a whole, it changes over time. It changes each month. Currently, the videos that are popular on my channel are all Star Wars toy videos. It's not Disney artwork. It's not Disney. I mean, there's one that's Disney Parks Tips that's like my huge, huge video. But it's not Disney anymore. It's Star Wars. You notice I quit wearing a Disney hat. Now I wear a Star Wars hat. Things change and I adapt. So given that the majority of my audience is Star Wars related, that's why my channel has shifted more towards Star Wars, because I see this as a business and I want to make sure it's a sustainable business, because if I could do this full time, that would be great. Currently, I work a part-time job, which is awesome. The fact that I can even do that and do this at the same time is great, but I'd like to be able to do this full time, and if doing so means I have to cater to the audience, and if the audience is skewed more towards people who want to watch Star Wars videos, that is what I'm going to put out. The thing I've noticed about the vlogs is that the vlogs don't get nearly as many views. In fact, on average, between 100 to 150 views, whereas I put out one Star Wars video, and it's going to get between 500 to 1,000 within about a week, which is great. And some of those videos go on to get about 1,000 views every 2 or 3 days, depending on what they are. If they're a lightsaber video, those are my gold mine right now. Just full transparency. That is what is bringing in money to buy more of this Star Wars stuff. That is what, that's my bread and butter right now, as you would say, is Star Wars toy videos, specifically lightsabers. Some of these action figures are doing actually pretty well for me, stuff like that. So that's why you're going to see a lot of that coming from the channel going forward, and why I want to move into Jurassic Park, because one of my also very popular videos is a video I did on my Jurassic Park collection of me and my kids at the park. That was a long time ago, and it was kind of a slow grower, but it ended up getting like 35,000 views or something. And so I'm like, you know what? That's what I'm investing in. I'm putting my time and effort into these videos that I may not see a ton of views all at once. It may not be all 7,000 something of you watching it all at once, but over time, I know I'm going to hit that 30, 40, 50, 60,000 views, and it's called evergreen content. Content that's going to constantly be watchable, whereas these vlogs are one time. There's going to be about 100 to 150 of you who watch this within the first 3 to 5 days, and afterwards nobody watches it because there's really nothing coming out of my mouth that is worthwhile other than my dialogue to you guys talking to you and letting you know what's up. And so for those 100 to 150 of you, you guys, I hold you like you're the friends. You're my good friends. You're the friends who are like come by no matter what, and I totally appreciate it and love you. But then there's the other part of the channel, which is everything else. And it's like, you are the core group. You're the good ones. Everybody's the good one. But you are the best ones. How about that? You guys are the best ones. So I literally make nothing off of these vlogs. These vlogs, I don't get revenue. It doesn't help my channel in any way. In fact, it hurts my channel sometimes because I do lose subscribers when I put out vlog videos. So that's why you've seen a little bit of a decline on me putting out vlogs, because it doesn't help my channel, because the majority of my audience is skewed towards younger males who want to see Star Wars toys. Now I'm an older male who loves Star Wars toys, so that kind of works out. But for those of you, the good ones, the best ones, I feel like I needed to explain that. That's what's been going on. That's why I haven't been doing the vlogs as much, is because I had a look mid-February. I got to be able to take a look and really look at the analytics for the last month for how January impacted, how the vlogs performed versus other videos. And it really, they underperformed. They underperformed and they hurt the channel. That being said, I don't want to not vlog. I like vlogging. I appreciate those of you who come out and watch these vlogs. Even if there's not, even you know, majority of my subscriber base, whatever that is, isn't the people who watch the vlogs. The people who watch the vlogs and comment and actually are interactive and watch the channel and leave me good feedback, like I said, you are the ones that I think about. I think about you when I make the videos. So it's that double-edged sword. I gotta balance like the people that my core audience that I really like and appreciate, and the people who don't leave comments, or the random strangers who come just to watch all the Star Wars videos, or the all the people who comment on my Holo Holo video, if you remember that. So this is something I get comments on like every day to every other day. I get 3 to 5 comments on the Holo Holo video from Jollibee. It's a Filipino dessert that apparently I ate wrong because I didn't mix it, and people feel the need to tell me that I should have mixed it. This is like a 2-year-old video at this point, and that's every day. 3 to 5 comments between 1 to 2 days I get feedback on, hey, you're supposed to mix it. Holo Holo means mix. So that's that. Either way, this is long. I've been rambling for 16 minutes straight. This is a very long vlog. So I hope you've made it this far. Let's go take a look outside and downstairs. Okay guys, so let's go downstairs. I wanna show you what's new around here. Look at that, there's a plant. There's another plant. So about, I think the last vlog I might have showed off a little bit, or at least on Instagram I showed off the changes that I'd made to our downstairs. I added some bamboo trim kinda everywhere. So I went along the ceiling, the corners, all of this biz back here, and I added some dark burned bamboo trim. I basically just split the rods and nailed them in, so you can kinda see them there up there. I think they look great. I think that, and I added some vines also. This is just the beginning. This is just the, when I said Jungle Cruise living room, you guys don't even know what I meant. Now, like I mentioned before in my other vlog, I have a lot of projects going on. So this is one of them. It's been a year, almost pretty much a year. We're in the beginning of March. That is like a year from when we had our floors done. and we first moved in, so yeah, it's about a year. And I'm a slow goer when it comes to my projects because I have my hands in so many different things. Plus, I don't ever consider anything done, like I said earlier. I don't ever finish my artwork. So, I started moving forward a little bit more on the Jungle Cruise living room. What do you guys think? Do you like that Jungle Cruise living room? I like the vines. I'm gonna add more. I'm gonna put more on the ceilings, like back in here, kind of going forward and same. And this, I need to take get more burnt bamboo and take it all the way down. But there's Maui's hook. I think I showed this before, but in case you guys didn't know how this worked. Oh yeah, it lights up. Now every time I do that, I knock it off the peg because it's not like on there. Oops. It's literally just the toy. It is like the toy, and I covered it in rope with some hot glue. And let's see if maybe, just maybe, I can get it back on there. Okay, it's on there. Ugh. I keep messing it up. And I keep breaking it. Yeah, this is a terrible idea. This is an awful, awful idea. But I did want to share this with you. I wanted you guys to see what I'm up to. I gotta like pull the nail out with my fingers now. Ah, way better. See, now it's like sticking out a lot. And there's the hole. Okay, it's a little better. I broke it. Oh my goodness, I broke it. I think the battery's finally died. It's not doing anything. Well, you had your run. And the thing is, I hot glued it, not super glued, but you're going here. I hot glued it, and I don't know how well that's going to stay. So, here's a little look into the kitchen. I had to stop with the bamboo there, and I had to stop with it like back there because it's as far as I could go is in that back corner with the amount that I had. So, I'm going to be doing more. Here's a little close-up. I don't think I showed you guys a close-up of the sign that I burned. There's a little elephant back there, and it says Colonel Hathi's Hideaway. If you know who Colonel Hathi is, then you are definitely a fan of The Jungle Book. Because that is directly what that is referencing is The Jungle Book. I'm trying one more time because I don't learn. Please stay. Oh, this is hard to do. And I'm actually going to have to like redo this. Please stay. Oh, and also real quick before I kind of end this. How about a question of the day? We haven't done one of these in a little while because I've been busy with other stuff. And the questions have been garbage. Either way, do you prefer the favorite or the underdog? Which one, the favorite or the underdog? I'm going to be posting this on social media later, Twitter, Facebook, all that good stuff. So if you see it there, answer there. If you want to comment here, and I will read it in the next vlog. Oh, you know what? Speaking of next vlog, I never answered my question about the Girl Scout cookies. Oh, they're all gone. I ate them all. Never mind. I ate the s'mores first, and we still have a little bit of Thin Mints left. So there you go. Either way, guys, I did want to give you an update as to what's going on with the little projects that I'm on, why my channel's been the way it's been lately, why you're going to see a ton of Star Wars videos in the next couple weeks. Also, I need to do dishes. And that's it for now, guys. Thank you so much for watching. You know I love you, especially you, the 150 or so who actually watch these vlogs. You guys mean the most to me. You really do. You really do, and I appreciate each and every one of you. So thank you so much. Until next time, you know the drill. May the force have with you, and goodbye forever.